Welcome to day two. Today we're going to create a button dropdown. I'm going to show you the design real fast. So this is what we're going to do. Probably this one. And we're going to reutilize the button. So basically this is going to, we're going to have a div around the button, and then we're going to have like the actual part that does the dropdown thingy. So let's get started, right? Okay, let's get started by defining the props. So the thing that I did was I created the example first so that the same thing doesn't happen. By the way, let me do this again. And let's see if this turns out an error. Or actually opens at any point. Okay, there we go. And we have my components. Open, isolated. This is all that the thing does. Okay. So first thing we need to do is the button contacts. This is the index file. That is the text file. So the button contact is going to be a string. This is gonna be what's gonna be inside of the button. So the thing we're gonna do is basically import the button. Let's start like that. Import button from, let's go back one and import button. Exactly. So now we're gonna use this button and we're gonna actually return a div. Let me create a div with a class name of style.button. Drop down wrapper, and now I can actually do this through here and close this div here, and we're gonna actually gonna import the button. So I'm gonna say button, and then I'm gonna put some text inside of it. In this case, the text is gonna be this app props that button contact. Okay, it says unexpected token because I forgot to close this. Okay, so now there's just this error because I forgot to open this. Is everything okay now? Yeah, it's just giving me the standard errors. And now we have a button that says components. Pretty damn slick, huh? Next, after that, we need to have the div that's actually going to be the dropdown. So, div with a class of button dropdown. Button dropdown icon. And this is going to have the HTML caret icon. Let me see how you actually do that. HTML caret. Okay, character thingies. Let's see if there's an HTML caret that I hope there is. So there isn't. Oh, there's no. Okay. So maybe there isn't one. Seriously? Okay, there we go. So this is the down one, and this is the one I have for one for now. So let's see if this works. Test constructor. Okay, good enough. Button drop down icon. Ah, style. That button drop down icon. Okay. See if this works. It totally works. So CSS question time, guys. I don't know why I'm really excited about this. So let's do this, and this is gonna have a position of relative. It's going to have a display of flex. And we're also going to set the background of it. So the background is going to be the same background as the primary. That is this. And the color is also going to be the same. So let me just delete this and this. And see how that looks. It looks exactly the same. Amazing. Because you're not recognizing this. And drop down wrapper. I don't know why I'm doing this. I think this. This is actually comes with the style loader. Style that button drop down wrapper. Amazing, guys. Why is this not working? So this happens to me actually a lot. I could never really understand why the hell this happens. But a lot of times I get this issue. Like, it doesn't recognize what I'm actually typing in there. So style.button drop down wrapper. So The thing is, if I come here and do this, the security should work, right? Okay, so that's another work. I guess that was my issue. Okay, so now we're gonna align all the items to the center. So just align item center, and just we don't need to justify. No, we need to justify contents, and no, we don't. Actually, just do this and see the size of that thingy. Drop down icon. Okay, and we go to Zeppelin again and check the size of this. This is 54 by 50. So, and that is the name of that. Drop down the icon. This is going to have a width of 54 and a height of 50. Width of 54 pixels and a height. And then we're going to have a height. We're going to have a padding with the button. Let me go see the actual padding of it exactly. And this is all going to be effective. So I'll just copy all of that. Okay, so did that work? No, of course it didn't, because I forgot to click this. Okay, anyway, that did not work. I mean, did it? No, it did. It did this thing. It just put it there. So, this should have flex roll at 0 and flex shrink at 1. That doesn't help anything. So, display inline flex. Exactly, so this is what I wanted. I wanted display inline flex, not flex. So display inline flex. There we go. And look at that. It looks kind of decent, halfway decent. Okay, this needs a border radius. So let me get the radius. This is calculator. I just want to for the right side. Let's go. Okay, no, all corners, 0. And I want the top right and bottom right to be 3. Bottom right to be 3, so this is the borders that I want for the icon finger. Okay, but, oh. Not even sure if this has it. Because I know it doesn't. Because this background touch might be in here, but this background touch is here. And now that looks worse. It's because I think it's bigger. So basically, this needs to go in here. And this port radius is the one we should go back. Let me just fix that. CSS lesson that I'm also learning. And there we go, 3. Yep. Damn it. So this needs to be 3 pixels all around, actually. Not 2, but 3 pixels. Does it look a bit? It looks a little bit. Okay, so the carrot isn't exactly the same. And we're also going to add a border. Let me check this. And we're going to have where is that one? There we go. We're going to have this border that is white. Okay. So, we're gonna have the padding is top and bottom. Oh shit. I need to have padding right for this border. So, I'm gonna check how the padding is doing. Let me come here. Just do something real quick and remove the width. And come here to the padding and make it with the same as the padding. So, this is 39, okay, 51, so 51, that's half a decent. Okay, so this is going to be 18 by 16. 18 by 16 pixels. Good. Okay. And there's not going to be any width, and there's going to be a border right, border left. Almost the same as white, as right, right? Okay, for the left of solid 1 pixel. There we go. So that looks decent, okay? Yeah, it's kind of not the top, but I'm okay with that. I'm also pretty okay with that, it looks pretty cool. Okay, so now we actually have to show the children. So, in the computer, and just put a div here. Div, it's gonna be this.props. that shit from. Okay. So that looks like shit. Am I right? You are right. Okay. Let me come here. The step of the children is missing in here, and the step of the children is an element. So, element. There we go. And, okay, let's give this a start. So, class name, this is the actual drop down. Style dot drop down. Right? Right. Okay, let's put an identifier. There we go. And we come here and do. And that drop down, and I'm just gonna set the position to absolute, and then we'll do the rest over here. So, exactly. So, how bad is this, guys? Horrible. Okay, so position absolute at the top is gonna be at 100%. Oh, we do have a problem with this. Oh, god, I forgot about this thing. React style guide is actually defines this as actually, it did. I'm not sure if it still does. Actually, I don't think it does anymore. Okay, so the top is just 100%. No, it does. Look, everything around here, where is that? That should be, it used to be at a preview. Is it here? No. Is it this? I think so, it's not even in my glass. Some drop down wrapper. Oh, no, I think it's okay, actually, but the thing is alright. Oh, they removed this, okay, great. So I'm gonna set the background equal to that background. It's an almost there as well. Yeah, they removed the thing that I was talking about. Never mind, this used to be, overflow hidden, and they kind of screwed up my things. Okay, so width is gonna be 100%. Okay, there we go. That looks horrible. That looks damn horrible, guys. What are we gonna do about this? Okay, so first thing, the background is not going to be this one. So the background is going to be a wider thing. Let me go to the variables here. So let me close this button and come here to the CSS and the variables. So that we have those right. So white is decent. Let me see. So white. There's no design for this. I think that looks decent. So I'm going to set it as white. Okay, so the top's going to be 100. And it's also. So the top is going to be 100%. It's gonna have the same border radius, the radius of 3 pixels. It's gonna have a background color of white. Var. God damn it. How did that thing appear? Okay, var. Figure it out how it appears. Var TVG. No, this is the old var. Yeah, see? Oh, I've gone crazy with TVG. So var white. And a width of 100%. And DUL inside of it, I don't know why I'm in caps lock, is gonna have a list style of none and a padding of 0. This is gonna have a padding of 10 pixels. 10 pixels. So that looks kinda like that. So this is the padding that the dropdown has, and the UL still has padding. Oh, yeah, margin as well, yeah. Margin 0. Okay, so a margin of 0, and I'm gonna go to the li, not the last chance, and I'm gonna pad the bottom of this by 10 pixels there. Okay, maybe, but, yes, yes. Okay, so this one is select the color, and the color is gonna be the one at the top, so color is gonna be this. Okay, guys, so that looks like shit, right? Yeah, Sarah. Thanks, guys. Oh, yeah, okay. Box sizing, border box. I don't know why this isn't defined over there. Okay, I have to define this in general, the way I'm defining the ladder thing. I don't know if you can spell that. So, box shadow, box sizing, building box. This is gonna ruin all the other things. I don't think so. No, it doesn't ruin anything. Okay. So that doesn't look like horrible. Yes. Good fact. Well. Okay, so let me add another thing here. So I need to add this, the button thingy. I need to come here. another primary over. Pen drop down, where is it? It's not SSS, okay. This over and cursor pointer. So it's not actually your button. And I don't know what, okay. So that looks pretty damn cool. Okay, so maybe I can do this a little different. So the button drop down, when we hover over it, when we hover over this, we change the background color. I think that makes way more sense. So that is weird. Oh. Okay, that's going down there. This is not supposed to be perfect, this is just supposed to work. Okay. So, thing is, we don't want to always show this, and we want to have a state in this application. I'm doing like the thingies. We want to have a state where this only appears when I click this. Okay, so let's set the initial state. Okay, so I need to set. Use for set type state, and type state will have an open nav that is going to be a boolean. Okay, so the name is, no, at least I can see them here. I think state, is that okay? Yeah, that's okay. So, and here I need to set this as state equals to open nav false. Okay, and we need to change this icon actually. So let's do that. And this is only gonna open if. So is that state that open it? And this, okay. And now I can press this. Let me just put this in here. And let's see if that thing doesn't show up anymore. It doesn't show up. It doesn't open either, but it doesn't show up. Okay, so this thing's the same thing. Now I keep opening the definition box. This thing's the same thing. Okay. So basically, I'm actually gonna do this here. So, no, this here, yeah. This, let's state, if I open it, show this, else show this. No, the thing is part of that, okay. So this. And this is actually strings. And this has an unexpected token because this is supposed to come in here. This is supposed to come. Move this. There we go. Okay, so if the set is open, show that one. If the set is not open, show the other one. This is totally working, guys. This is like incredibly. Oh, it is working. I just got that in here. Oh, no, it isn't. So I need to do it like this. Okay. I shouldn't need this. But it gives me a parsing error. I'm gonna set the counts here, so that should. Obviously, all the problems. So const down equals this. Oh, this gives me a person error. Okay, escape HTML because we add. I don't care about JSX. Okay. If this works. Copy this over here. Yeah, okay, this works. Okay, let me come here and do the same thing for this one. Okay, so there's the yellow one. And that. That's what I need. Okay, problem solved. Okay, so this is the better than this goes, okay? So, the idea is, if I click the button or the thingy, so I'm going to say unclick, and I'm going to run one function that is in this. And I'm going to add this, that handle, drop down. Good, yeah. So first of all, I'm going to create that function. So, handle drop down. State used to be before that, I think. This is a problem with the state. And I need to set this function in here. So this, that on the drop down equals this, and on the drop down that binds this. And let me do this before I set the after I set the state. Let's do this, okay. Okay, that's the problem. I'll do something over here. Okay, so all I'm gonna do here is set this, that. Set state, and I'm gonna set the open to true, and I set the open here so I'm drop down receives nothing. Then receives nothing and void. That this is how you do it. No, no, I do this, okay. The type flow function definition. Definition, okay. The type, okay. Oh, I want to actually, like, doesn't return anything. No, this is not it. Definition. That's good. Okay, so that's the only one. There's another way to do this, but I don't quite remember how, because this is dumb, because this isn't returning anything. Okay, so basically all I'm going to do is set this. It's void, that doesn't make any sense. Okay, I can check that out later. Okay, so open text to true, and this has a problem, expected token and the drop down. That's true. Okay, so someone has a covariant thingy. So if that works. Amazing. So that doesn't work on the reverse though, because I want to set this to at this dot state dot opening. Which I just baby works now. That baby works amazing. I can't, it kind of looks like a hermit, but okay, if I click this, nothing happens, so basically, this thingy needs to be an actual button too, but otherwise, you shouldn't be creating things around buttons to add on click thingies and on. Okay, so that works too, and then let me set this button, that is the button drop down icon, to have an outline of none, and a border of none. Basically an inline button, it doesn't have background. So this is its background color. And it also needs the color because button. As you can see, this works perfectly. more of us like, oh, this works perfectly. Now, all the person has to do is actually set this. So set a URL. You can put age, you can put anything you want in there, and it works. I think that's pretty much all we need to do. I mean, there's this problem thingy in the... I need to check how to do this. I think it's this step. No. Set return functions. I think it's this. Like, you set... Okay, state that to that state. So, enter drop down. Okay, to that, this, and void. Is that it? Yeah. Figured it out on my own. Super pro. So basically this receives nothing and returns void. This doesn't actually return anything. So I think that's pretty much it. That was actually pretty fast. It's actually pretty fast, wasn't it? So it's not perfect. Because of mainly because of the spacing. And because of the hover thingies. But it's not bad. Like, it works fine. I think we have some time for tests. Shall we? Shall we do tests? Yes, yes. Okay, so, what is the error that is in here? Oh, this is the plane. Never mind. Oh, it's the class name things. Oh, this one doesn't have... Oh, okay, I'm not using class names in here. I can actually delete this. Okay. So that was actually pretty damn easy. Okay, so I have an index.html here. And I'm gonna untag this. Button drop down. Little button drop down with a text. And I can actually set the class. So the class is gonna drop down. And I hope the test will be this. Let's see if that works. Let me drop down. Okay. Oh, I don't know why I just did that. So let me just. This is always. Oh god. Interest. Oh, I've actually got the atom to show the coverage, and so now we're seeing the coverage. Reactive tools are doing. Oh, yeah. Oh, so yeah. It also receives this, which is not cool. Because this is HTML. No, it doesn't make any sense. So props up on contact. Because the state isn't open, so this is correct, actually. So let me copy this, because it actually renders it as a. We come here and copy this. Come to the button drop down. See, we just catch the problem. And let me run this again. See, I'm dressed. I don't know how to take that error. If anyone knows, please just let me know because I have no idea. And where's the coverage? That coverage. Okay, let me open this index. Open Chrome. Get rid of the button drop down. Index. Okay. So now we have to set states. So setting state. I've done this, but I don't remember. Just tests. I can close this. There's no React apps. Oh, first of all, let me try to see. Let me just see something. And find the button drop down, and I'm gonna simulate button drop down and find. Primary and start simulate click simulate. I'm gonna simulate a click and I'm gonna see if this has a test. No, oh, it worked, amazing. So this worked. So, but I did it the wrong way, yeah. Down. Okay, so test. It actually changed. So the state is different. Go and drop down. Then this chicken on click. Amazing. Just pretty damn amazing, guys. What is that state is okay. I think that's actually one thing to check state, simulate change and check for that text. Yeah. Basically you simulate the change and you test it then it doesn't. So everything's tested. Is there anything else we need to test here? Okay, so no, I think that's pretty much it. That's all the testing we actually need to do. Let me just test with so much demo to see. Precision, so I'm gonna put a P in here. The test, and then undo the P. I think this was actually a lot easier than the buttons, which is kind of weird. Drop down. Where is that? That's find. I'll find. Drop down. HTML. This is probably going to give me an error because it always does. Let me see what they expect it to be. Yeah, I need a P. So, P, P, test, just test, just P test. Is it an error? Okay, so I had an absolute snapshot. Let me just run new. You do it. And I passed it. I'm gonna try and fix this issue. But that's the past. And we have a drop down. Is it perfect? I think the styling is perfect. And I will upgrade on the styling or add a drop down option to the button or something. I'll think about it. But the functionality is there. As you can see, it works. I can set A's in here. Let me just check if that works. So A, we're going to drop that is equal to http://google.com and close that in. Just click this and we go to Google. Oh, I actually typed Google wrong. I just let it go. And I'm going to get the styles and do the drop in and URL. And I'm going to set the age, what's the color, drop down. And maybe I have this color. And other, oh, and the text, and that's the decoration of none. And the other is gonna have this color but darken by 10%. So color, D, no, it's not D, it's B. B, okay, and 10, plus 10, plus 10%, no. Is it like this? God damn it, I can never do this. Unclose bracket. What? Oh! I don't think this is it either. Yeah, this is gonna give me another one. So, god damn, it's the other video that's uploaded to YouTube. So, B, and I think this is probably it. No? No. This is still in here. I'll try and do this before I really place on Google. Yeah! No! No, it did not work. Unable to parse color from strong. Okay, we need to go to the buttons again and check how I did that. Oh, you did that with the help of Google. Yes, I did. Okay, so this is it. Nothing here. So color var. Oh, okay. So color var and the B goes in there. Oh, that kind of makes sense, I guess. Because I'm blackening it by 10%. Blackening it. There you go. What? Dude, seriously? Yeah. Plus 10%. Why do I have three things in here? Uncle's bracket. So, what? This goes in here. Okay, is that it? No. Unable to parse color from string. Does it? That it? No, didn't do anything. Oh, yeah, I know why you didn't do anything because I forgot to do it. Yeah, okay, so that works. Yeah, that's it. It took a while to do that. It was more of a CSS lesson right there. But we have our button drop downs. Look at it go, it's amazing. So all it gets is a button content and it's actual children. So there we go. We can look at our creation right now. We have buttons and then drop down. I will fix this later probably. Then create the button should have like a prop that should find if the button is dropped down or not. But right now I'm doing it this way because I have 30 days to create 30 components, and let's be honest. It's not too bad actually. It just has that little problem in there because of the things, and I could fix this. Let me try and fix this before we go, because that's actually a bit too fast than I thought. So this one was, and the problem with this one is that the padding doesn't get over time. So if I set this to 17, wait, does that look like shit now? Because that one is bigger now. The thing is, I'm gonna fix this, guys. I swear to God. Where is this? There we go. Wait, maybe when you watch this, you can turn on the thingy if you want. So 16. It's not really 16. Okay. We come in here and the margin left should be minus 1. Margin left, minus 1 pixel. So that it hides the thing. And it's 2 pixels and it hides the thing. And the height should, the main height should be 50 pixels. Min height should be 49 pixels. So if I do this, it works much better now. Yeah. Do it, fix it. So imagine I should do this. I need to remove this from here. And imagine I took the drop down icon. No, this needs to be here. This can be done. Remove from here. This needs here. Okay, min height 49. Let me load a page, otherwise I can never tell if it's fixed or not. Oh yeah, and now we need to put relatives on that side. So I'm gonna say create a radius to this of 3 pixels. 3 pixels 0, 0. Oh, that's not it. That's not it. So, take a 0, 3, I don't know why I did that. 0, 3 pixels. And there we go. We have a much prettier thingy. Much way prettier, yeah. Like if we used actual like icons, this little thingy wouldn't happen. And could actually make a prettier thingy out of this, but this is what we have, right? There's no design for this, so this is what we have. And I think it's really great for like 30 minutes or something. So I'll see you guys tomorrow.